In this example, here the figure shows a wire loop made up of a wire having a resistance R ohms per meter and a normal magnetic field is applied on the loop of which magnitude varies with time as 4 kT square Tesla with the value of K is a constant too. We are required to find the current in the loop at T equals to 4 seconds. Now in this situation, here we can directly state that the total resistance of this loop, if we calculate, resistance of loop can be directly given as R is total length multiplied by small r. So here total length can be written as 4 times A plus B, this multiplied by R. This much ohms will be the total resistance of the loop. Now due to variation in this magnetic field in inward direction, which is increasing here with the time. So by Lenz's law we can say if inward direction magnetic field is increasing, in both of these loops EMF induced will be anti-clockwise in nature so as to oppose the external increment in magnetic induction. So if we calculate EMF induced in bigger loop, then this bigger loop which is of side as B, the EMF induced can be written as E1, which is area multiplied by dB by dt. So here the area of this loop is B square and dB by dt. Here we can see it is 8 kT. And we are required to find the current at T equals to 4 seconds. So if we substitute T is equals to 4 and K is equals to 2, then this will be 64 B square. That is at time T equals to 4 seconds. Similarly, if we calculate EMF induced in a smaller loop, then loop EMF induced in the smaller loop, we can again use the formula A dB by dt. Here the area of the smaller loop is A square dB by dt is again 8 kT. On substituting the values, this is 64 A square. Here we have seen that as magnetic induction is increasing in inward direction, so the EMF induced will be anticlockwise here and here also this will be E1, this will be E2. And you can see the current induced due to this EMF, current induced due to this EMF, both will oppose each other. So we can directly write current in loop is, there's a combined loop in which both the loops are connected to each other. So total current we can write as E1 minus E2 divided by total resistance because the two EMF currents are opposing each other. So in this situation if we substitute the values, this will be 64 B square minus A square divided by the total resistance which is 4 times A plus B R. And further simplifying, the result we are getting is 16 B minus A divided by R. That will be the answer to this problem.